In this video I'm going to show you how you can move your WordPress website from one hosting to another hosting. And what we will be doing in this video is we will be moving our WordPress website from my local host. As you see, this is located on my local server, and this is if it would be on another hosting provider, and we will be moving it to HostGator. And as you remember in last video, I told you that I will be using this, if you go into web hosting, this baby plan, so you can add or create unlimited websites on host unlimited websites on this baby plan. And like I mentioned in the previous video, if you are going to host your WordPress websites and use baby plan, don't get this WordPress hosting, because baby plan is great and it does the job, and you can host as many websites as you want. As you see here, you could be able to host only 3 sites or 2 sites or even 1 site. But if you go into web hosting, with baby plan you can host unlimited domains, and it will be cheaper at the end of the day if you are planning to host more than one website. Tutorials, as you see, this one is already hosted in there, but I will be removing it from this because I created this website couple of months ago, or half a year ago, and I'm not really using it, so I decided to create a tutorial, and we will be moving this website which we are training and where we are working, where we are implementing different plugins, and this is what we are going to move to the hosting provider. So once you will buy, guys, this baby plan and you will have it, you will receive an email, and your email will be with your contact details like HostGator, your account info, which will include all information about your hosting, which will include name servers. For example, if you would want to move your domain name from another domain name provider to this hosting, then you will need to change these name servers, as you know, guys. And if you don't know how to move name servers of your domain name, just let me know and I will show you that as well. But in this video I will not be getting into name servers, we will be just moving one website with its database to another hosting, from our local host to HostGator, and we will be moving this website. Okay guys, enough talking, and once you will receive this, you will also get your control panel link, as you see here in your email from HostGator. You just will need to click that link and you will need to log in. This is standard account, this is cPanel, which has one user interface which they have added. Let's grab our website from our local environment. Let's grab this website which is my site, and let's store it in zipped folders on our computer. So as you remember, guys, to go there, you go to this PC, a local disk, and you go into XAMPP and you go into htdocs, and here is my site. Just once click on it, then right click on it, send to zipped folder. That's what we need to do, we need to send it to zipped folder, so we zip all files which are there. Then while it is sending it to zipped folder, let's go into localhost and phpMyAdmin, and let's grab database as well. So localhost/ phpMyAdmin. As you remember, when we created that site, I called database my site as well. So click on this my site. Once we are in database my site here, you go here into export tab on top, and here click go, because we will be simply exporting this file. So click go. This will store it as mysite.sql in your downloads direct. So now we have this database and we have our folder where is all file for front end of our website. Now we can close this localhost database, we can close this site, we can close this, and we can close this because we will not need it anymore. And now next thing what we need to do, we go into file manager, and once you are in file manager, go into public HTML, because that's where all your folders are stored. Currently I have here a lots of folders, and this is from my Shard tutorial old website. I will just remove them, delete them. So delete, confirm, and this will delete it completely. And now we need to here in this public HTML folder in file manager to import the folder from htdocs, which is my site, and then we will extract it here. So how we do it, we simply click here upload, then we select files, And as you remember, we go into local disk, we go into XAMPP, HD docs, and we click on this my site and click open. Okay, and now it will send all our files to our hosting. This is front-end files, this is not database yet because we need to create database. So while it's sending files, we could go probably and create a database. So go back to your HostGator control panel and here you will find this MySQL databases. As you see, MySQL databases, that's where we need to click in. We will create here a new database. I will be deleting all these guys so you can see now how it works. And as you see, there is a prefix Bugatti underscore and whatever database name, and I will call this database name Bugatti underscore my site. I'm adding after Bugatti underscore my site, that will be database name, not only my site, but in front we will have Bugatti and underscore, and create database created. Go back, and now we need to create a user. Let's create a user for this database, and as you see, MySQL users, add new user, and here Bugatti underscore, I will create user site because I will be removing this after this tutorial, guys. So I create username the same as database name, so I say my site, and you can add some password here, whatever password you want, and create user. And now you see we have created the user Bugatti my site as well. So my database is Bugatti my site and my username is as well Bugatti my site. And let's go back. Normally you don't do it, but this is only for purpose of this video. Normally you would create another username, different name as database name. And now we need to add our user to our database. So user, as you see, is Bugatti my site, as you remember we created, and database name is Bugatti my site as well, and click add, and then we give all privileges to this user to access this database. This pretty much means that this particular website will be able to access all these files in that database and make changes. And once you have made changes, again we go back. So we have now database created and we have user created. So let's go back to control panel by clicking here on top, and here we will go into phpMyAdmin, and in phpMyAdmin we will databases, okay, databases, click into databases, then go into here on top, then go into Bugatti my site because that's the database which we created, and now we click here import, and here we need to choose file which we downloaded or exported from our site on our local environment. As you remember, it was in downloads, my site.sql. As you see, my site.sql, and open it and go. So it imports all our files with all data, with everything to this database. As you see, import has successfully finished, 65 queries executed. This means that now if we go into Bugatti my site, we see that all our WordPress tables, sorry guys, are imported. So database is done and user is added. We will only need to change it a little bit later in vp-config file to allow access to this particular user to this database. So now this is now imported. Now we go back where we extracted, imported this mysite.zip file, and we go back to our home. We have here this file. So right click on it, and here we say extract, okay, and just runs this open in public.html, extract files. So it will extract all this folder and close. And now what we need to do next is we need to delete this zipped file. So let's delete it, okay, confirm, and then we go into this extracted one, my site, click into it, and just left click and or highlight all files, because we need to send these files back to this public underscore html folder, otherwise it will not see this index file and this site will not work. So right click here, move, and we go public underscore html my site, but we delete my site, so we move it to public underscore html and move files. And now if we click in public html, We see that all our files are here, and now we can delete this my site directory with all those files because we don't need that as well. That was the one which was extracted. So right click on it and let's delete it. And yes guys, this is pretty much it, and this is stored under sharktutorials.com. So let's click on sharktutorials.com and let's have a look what is going on. And as you see, error establishing database connection, and this is because in these files in file manager, in VP config file, we have old database connection from our local environment which we need to change now. And to do this, we go into VP config. As you see, here is VP config file, and we need to open it and change to all new database user and database password to add a new database name. So we click on this and we go code editor here on top, click on code editor, and it will open that file, and click edit, and this will open this config file. And here you will see MySQL database username. It is at the very beginning, and as you see, DB user, we don't have DB user. As you remember, I changed it from root. It is not root anymore because root, it was on my local environment. Here it is Bugatti underscore my site. We changed, and DB password, we had the DB password, whatever you added there, Bugatti123 I added as DB password. And DB host, we leave local host if your database is not on another server, but normally it will not be on another server. Your database username is Bugatti my site, and your database password is Bugatti123. And database host will be local host, guys. Database name, here we need to change it as well. It is DB name, it's my site. We need to add Bugatti underscore in front of this DB name as well, guys. And click save changes here on the right top corner. And then if we go back to our Shark Tutorials, which is our website and domain. And yes, guys, here it is. This is how this site now looks, and this is under Shark Tutorials. And as you see, we imported and we moved it from our local site, which is local site, as you remember, from localhost my site. This is this one, which is now on my localhost, and this is which I have moved to sharktutorials.com website. This is how you move your WordPress website from one hosting provider to another hosting provider. And if you found this video useful, guys, leave a like, share this video, and subscribe to my channel, and see you in my other videos.